Alright, so I thought I'd show how you can take the Chevy Volt and run it without a battery. Now, I am not talking about a lithium-ion battery that runs down the middle of the car and behind the rear seats. And I'm not talking about the lead-acid battery, which, by the way, is not located under the hood. It is actually located near the back cargo storage. If you pull these, you can see the contact points for jumping it. So it's right under there, and you can pull four screws in the corners to pull this up and get to it. But like I said, this is not the battery I'm talking about. The one I'm talking about is in here. So, as I mentioned, this is the battery that we're talking about, and the key fob. First off, key fob and the keyless entry work great. There is this key that can be used in the door. And then as long as you've got a good battery, it works pretty well. All right, so normally when you get into the car, you have the key, car is locked, you walk up to it, hit the button, unlocks, get in easily. Once inside, you're able to press the button. Assuming your foot is on the brake, everything starts up just fine. And back off. But what happens when the battery dies? Is there another option? Well, it turns out there is. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to pop the case and remove the battery. Okay, now I have taken the battery out of the remote, so we'll see what happens. I walk up to the car, hit the button, nothing happens, but I have this key that I can use to unlock the car. Now, what's going to happen when I open the door? It starts panicking. What? Now it stopped. So, in order to do that, I placed the key without the battery into this little hole. Now, it doesn't fit well. It simply basically falls down in that void, and that tells the car it's okay to start. There is no place to put the key on the steering wheel column. Take a look. There's nothing there, no keyhole, nothing on the dash. One thing you have to do once you get in the car is go to this top storage, and you'll see a plug there. That's not what you need. What you need is to remove this mat that sits in here. And then once you've started the car, you can remove the key. It'll continue to work. So I hope you've enjoyed this quick little look at a way to start your Chevy Volt without a battery. And you'll see it just slips in there just underneath the edge
right there, and then hits those contacts, and then putting it back on. Just have to make sure the battery doesn't slip out while you push that back on. The button, and put the key back.
If you like this content, please be sure to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and give us a like. Thanks.